Respected Comrade President of CITU, Comrade General Secretary, and comrades from sister organizations who have come to felicitate this conference, and other comrades on the dais and fellow comrades. I am privileged to be in your midst this morning and to felicitate this conference, not only on my behalf, but also on behalf of INTUC and its President, Dr. Sanjeev Reddy. Dr. Sanjeev Reddy has requested me to convey his profound apologies for his inability to attend this conference. And we are meeting after one day's historic strike on January 2020. This strike has been really historic for two reasons. Number one, a large number of organizations who are not officially in the All India Coordination Committee have also joined the strike along with us. Secondly, the farmers organizations, they also synchronize their program along with us and express their solidarity with us. Consequently, the strike has paralyzed not only the urban areas, but also the rural areas. I know during your stay here, you would be discussing, deliberating, and taking some decisions on certain vital issues that are important to labor and working class. Already two issues, you have passed resolutions. And I would like to take this opportunity to underline a few of the other issues. Number one is national economy. The national economy is in doldrums. You know very well, every day the media carries a report about the national economy, and it is falling down. That is mainly because of the government's wrong policies and their actions. The government, all the experts, and particularly the economic experts, have substantiated their claim with facts and figures to show that the economy is in doldrums. The government is cornered, but the government does not accept it directly or change its policies. As workers and working part of the working class, we have a vested interest in the economic development because we are the people who contribute to the economy of this country. And if the economic situation goes down, the workers are the workers and toiling masses are the first section of the people who are affected by that. So this has to be borne in mind while passing resolutions. Then the public sector. The public sector has been built up for the last 70 years with very great difficulty. Even Jawaharlal Nehru termed the public sector as temples of modern India. But today's government is systematically demolishing public sector, and they are trying to privatize or sell it to the corporates. Even important sectors like railways, defense, they are not any exemption are not there. Coal, exemptions are not there, but they are also being privatized. And we have to stop this privatization, because we know very well that when other countries were very much affected by economic crisis, our country was not that much affected. That is because we had a mixed economy and a strong public sector. Therefore, as workers, we know very well the importance of the public sector and its necessity. So we have to face this squarely. Then issues of employment. Almost the permanent employment is vanishing. Casual labor is taking place. And contractualization is taking place. Now the fixed term employment has come. And these things reduce our wages, and there is inequality in income distribution, and we are not able to record sustainable economic growth. And therefore, the employment issue we have to take, and even the minimum wages, which are fixed, which are recommended by the government's own committees, are not being respected by the government. And therefore, this has to be borne in mind. Then again, the labor code. Much less is said about the labor codes. Yes, workers also, trade unions also wanted there should be comprehensive labor legislations. We have 44 labor legislations at the center, and we have umpteen number of labor legislations at the state, because labor is the concurrent subject. But not this way. We wanted codification, but not this way. What they have done with the name of codification, all the nefarious clauses they have introduced. And all the benefits, beneficial clauses, beneficial sections in the labor enactments have been taken away. And therefore, trade unions have squarely rejected this labor code, and yet the government appears to be very bent upon in introducing the labor code and implementing it. And that also is one of the issues that we have to take it in this conference. Then again, tampering with the banking institutions. Every day, day out, media carries some businessman who have defrauded the banks, defrauded the country, are vanishing and are fleeing out of the country. And it is a very sad commentary to say that the government itself is a tool for that. Government helps the business people to go out, and then they say that we are trying to get them back. And not only that, the banks have now, the government has now embarked upon the merger of banks. The merger of banks is not just for increasing the efficiency, but only to hide the government's follies, corrupt bureaucrats, and also the NPAs. Non-performing assets have grown, and by that process, the public funds have been squandered away, and they have taken the money abroad. And therefore, this tampering of the banking institutions, banking system, should be stopped. And therefore, I would like this conference to keep in mind that the tampering of the banking system has to be stopped. Then again, we all know that the present government, from the beginning, has been adopting a policy of pro-corporate. They have been helping the corporate sector, corporate business, much against the small business and much against the uplifting of the poor and common people. And this has to be stopped. And these things we have already discussed on many platforms, and we have also had a discussion on various programs of the central organizations. Then again, you all know that democracy and unity in diversity are two pillars which India is proud of. India is a great democratic country, and for which we are proud of it. And now, unity in diversity also is one of the portals of our system, which even the foreign countries, even the other countries, they are envy of. Here, people live, in spite of diversity, people live peacefully. But this government is trying to demolish that unity also by dividing the people on grounds of caste, religion, and other things. And the earlier resolution you have adopted is on that, particularly the ongoing disputes, ongoing struggles that is going on not only among the working class but also in the country. And democratic demolition of democracy also is being resorted to by demolishing, by tampering with the constitution of this country, and therefore this has to be stopped. And you have got a very great responsibility in doing that. Then finally, friends, I would not like to take much of your time because paucity of time, and there are others also to facilitate this conference, and therefore I once again wish you all success and very useful deliberations and great success for this conference. Thank you very much.